everyone. Hope you've had an enjoyable week. Another video for you, and this week we're back to ballroom, and we're going to actually do the Viennese waltz. We don't very often teach the actual Viennese waltz in group classes. It's the dance that people see, oh my god, it's the spinny dance that everyone gets dizzy. It's that dance. Obviously, if you have private lessons and things, we will teach it if people ask, but it does tend to be the dance that people don't necessarily teach that often, mainly because of the rotational kind of feel to it. But it's not as rotational as you think when you get used to doing the steps. And actually, talking of the steps, if you did our waltz video, which was quite a few weeks ago now, the steps that we did in that are actually the steps in the Viennese waltz. The Viennese waltz doesn't actually have that many steps. It has a natural turn, a reverse turn, change step, either forwards or backwards, and then something called the fleckle, which is the move that you see people do in the middle of the floor. Okay, and so if we go back to the waltz video, we did the natural turn, change step, reverse turn. But obviously the waltz is slower. The Viennese waltz is quicker, but it's still the three beats. One, two, three. Obviously then we do the four, five, six, but it is still the three beats. Okay, so I'm going to teach the follower steps and Ian will teach the leader steps. So we're going back to a video a bit like that today. Okay. So we're going to do, I will go teach you the natural turn and the reverse turn. And obviously to link those two moves together, you do a change step. But all we're going to teach you today is for the followers, the backward change step, and for the leaders, the forward change step. Like I say, there is one the other way around as well, but don't want to overcomplicate things. Okay, so natural turn always turns to our right. Reverse turn turns to the left, okay? Or if you want to think of it clockwise and anti-clockwise, whichever way is easy for you to think about it. So, natural turn first. So I will turn around, most you will see, because obviously it goes around the floor, again like all the ballroom dances, you will kind of see slightly different angles of me all the time. Whereas the Latin, I can pretty much either stay forwards or backwards, okay? So, natural turn first. So it goes back, or straight through, back on the left leg, to the side on the right leg, close left to right. Now it's the same principle as waltz. Because I've closed my left leg, then I'm going to go forward on my right leg. Okay, so let me just do that again. So I go back on my left, back, side, close, which is the first part of the natural turn, one, two, three. Now the second part, four, five, six, which is going to go forward on my right foot, to the side on my left, and close my right to my left. Okay, so I'll just show that again. So it goes one, two, three, four, five, six. Okay, just one thing, because Viennese waltz is quicker, the waltz obviously has the down, up, the down, up, up, that the swing movement. Viennese waltz, you can't do that so much. That's one thing that people kind of get wrong in Viennese waltz and still try to go up and down. With the speed, you will not be able to do the rise and fall so much. There's still heels and toes, but you don't have the rise and fall. You keep the control within the knees. Okay, so you don't have such bobbing up and down, because if not, you end up just skipping and hopping. Okay, so let me just do the natural turn again. So it goes one, two, three, four, five, six. And if I repeat, so it goes around the floor, one, two, three, four, five, six. Okay, so it rotates around the floor. So that's the natural turn. Now the reverse turn. Okay, there's just one step in this that's slightly different in the reverse turn to the natural turn, okay? So it starts, because the natural turn starts on our left, the reverse turn is going to start on our right, and it's turning to our left. So we've got, we go back on our right foot, so 1, 2, 3, so it goes, sorry, I should say the steps first, back, side, close. Now because we've closed our right foot in, we're going to go forward on our left, forward to the side. Now instead of closing, our left foot crosses in front of the right foot, okay, on the sixth step. So it goes 1, 2, 3, step 1, 2, 3. Now step 4, 5, 6. Okay, so if I show you that this way, so it goes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so show you this way, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And you would go again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, some people, reverse turn can feel a little bit awkward because it is on the reverse turn. You've got the shaping can be a bit more difficult. Okay, so what the principles of what we always say about turning is remembering who is on the inside and outside of turn. So you need to remember those principles. If you're both trying to go the same distance, you won't get around each other. Okay, so let me just show you the steps first, and then I'll explain the inside, and I'll break them down and show the inside and outside of turn. So that's the natural turn. Okay, so the natural turn starts on left, left, right, close. Now forward on the right, forward, side, close. Reverse turn starts on our right foot, back, side, close, forward, side, cross. Okay, now obviously we need to link those two moves together, because if you just keep doing reverse all the way around the floor or natural all the way around the floor, you will actually get dizzy. Okay, so we change from reverse to natural, natural to reverse. Okay, so we keep transferring back. So I'm going to do reverse to start, and then I'll show you the change step. So I'll go, I'm going to do natural first, then into the change step. So natural turn with our left leg. So it goes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so the change step, we've just closed our right foot in. So the change step, we're going to go back on our left foot. Okay, they say to the side, but it's diagonally back on your right foot and close your left foot in. Now you can go off on your right foot to do the reverse turn. So that is, again, the change step is back on the left, to the side and slightly back on the right to close the left. Now you can do the reverse turn, so which would be back, side, close, forward on the left, side, cross. Okay, the reason you don't on the, sorry, I'm talking, I need to turn this way, don't I? The reason you don't want to go straight to the side on the change step, so you don't want to go back, side, close, because with momentum, you'll both just crash, basically, because with the momentum and the power, if you just put the side step on, it's basically like doing an emergency stop in a car. Okay, so if you think, if you've got the rotation going round and then all of a sudden you just throw a side step in, it's going to throw you, and it will also make you shift off each other as a partnership. Okay, so you need to remember it's back, diagonally back, so you're creating that space to come through, close. Okay, I don't want to get too complicated. Okay, now the change step again, like I say, we're going to do another backward change step for the followers. So obviously we've got to then get from reverse into natural. So let me do the reverse turn, so which will be back on the right. So back, side, close, forward, side, cross. Now it's exactly the same principle as from the natural, but we just don't know the foot. So it's going to go back on the right, diagonally back on the left, close right into left. So now you can go back into your natural turn, back, side, close, forward, side, close. Okay, hope that makes sense. So change step, I'll just do this step. So change step from natural to reverse. Okay, so you've gone, so natural to reverse will be on the left foot. So it'll be left, right, close. Then you can go off onto the reverse turn. You've just finished the, so that's from natural to reverse. Now reverse to natural, the change step. So the reverse turn, you'll finish cross leg, right, left in front of right. So now you've got the change step. So it's going to go back on the right, left, right, which closes. So now you can go back off into the natural turn. Okay, hope that makes sense. So what I'll try and do is a natural turn, a change step and a reverse turn. Not too sure how much you'll see. Obviously you wouldn't just do one change because it would be too much. What you tend to want to do or not to do, you don't really want to do reverse turn on a corner because it makes it a lot harder. Obviously it's very difficult, it's dependent on the floor as well, in terms of when you do the change step. You can, when you get more advanced, you will do it to the music and the changing in the phrasing. But generally try to just work out in terms of with the floor and try to avoid doing reverse turn on a corner. Have a go, you'll see, you'll see why. Okay, so I'm just going to show one natural, change step, one reverse, then a change step. Like I say, I'm not too sure how much you'll see. I'll do my best, okay? So we've got a natural turn. So it goes one, two, three, four, change step, change step. Now reverse turn, two, three, four, five, six, into change step. See, I've gone around the corner now, so back into the natural turn. A change step, into the reverse turn, into a change step, into the natural turn. Okay, hope that makes sense. The main principle is remembering to keep changing the weight, keep changing the feet, like we do in waltz. So when you close your feet, if you close left to right, you need to come out on the right foot. Okay, that's the basic principle. If you can keep remembering that it's a different foot each time. Okay, I just explain about the inside and outside of turn, which I just said earlier. So the principle, if you're on the inside of turn, you will do a slightly smaller step to allow the person to come around the outside, because obviously if you do a big step on the inside, they've got then, your partner's then got to do a really big step. Okay, so for us as followers, natural turn, we're on the inside of the turn on the first three steps. Okay, so we do them smaller, one, two, three. Now we're on the outside of the turn on the second part, so we will take bigger steps. Okay, reverse turn again is the opposite way around, reverse. So we're on the inside of the turn here, so one, two, three. We're now on the outside of the turn, four, five, six. Okay. So remember, whenever you're on the inside of the turn, you do the smaller steps. When you're outside of the turn, you do the slightly bigger steps to allow your partner to get around each other. But that does take time. Okay. Also, another quick tip. Don't think you have to, in the six steps, get all the way from back to forward. People think that that's what we need to do. And then that's when you will get dizzy as well, because you're trying to do too much rotation. Okay. Actually, what you need to do, you go back to the side and then you finish diagonal to center. Okay. So because then on the next step, we start to use our body to allow us to go into the next movement. Again, remember the waltz, back to the waltz video when I started to, we were doing these exercises. Okay. That's all this again, the principle of, you don't have to be a block all the way round you will really struggle to get around each other. So by doing less of a turn, you are actually more narrow to each other. So you are more of a narrow angle, so it's thinner, so then it's easier to get past each other. If you're flat to each other, you're just basically blocking each other. Okay, so just show that again. So I would go back, side, diagonal to center. Now, on this next step, then I go down the line. There. Okay? Then diagonal center again. Now I complete the turn. Okay, sorry about the camera. Okay, hope that makes sense. But again, just get the basic principle of the steps first. Then you can work on the other things. I'm just going to, I will demonstrate it to music, but just so you get the idea of kind of the speed of the Viennese waltz. Because like I say, it is quicker than the slow waltz. So I will do what I've just demonstrated. So I'm going to do a natural turn, change step, reverse turn. But just so you get the principle of the music. So Alexa, play Breakaway by Kelly Clarkson.
Breakaway by Kelly Clarkson from Janine's Spotify.
Okay, so. Goes on one, so. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Change. Reverse. Change. Change. Now reverse. Remember to cross. Change. Natural. Change. Okay. So. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Alexa, stop. Okay, hence why you can't get too much down and up action, because to the speed you will not get it. It's across the floor. Okay, so that's the followers steps. As I say, now Ian's video will follow, and he will teach the leader steps. They're basically just the reverse. But obviously, it's still obviously important, because the leaders are going, the driver, when we're going backwards, the leaders are obviously going forward. Okay? So I hope you've enjoyed that. Any questions? Because like I say, the Viennese waltz is quite complicated, even though, like I say, there's not many steps. It's the understanding of the technique and how it works with each other, which is more difficult. But as I say, we thought we would do a video on it, because we don't necessarily teach it in the classes that often. This video gives you a chance, because, you know, we've all got quite a bit of time on our hands at the moment. Things are easing, but there is still a bit of time. So it's good for you to give a go. And the more you can get used to rotation, the easier the dancing becomes, because dancing ballroom, we start to really develop. The more advanced we get, the more rotational movements we do. So if you can get used to getting rotation in the feet and through the body, it's a really good skill to have. Okay, so I'll stop babbling now. So I hope you enjoyed the video. As I say, Ian's video will follow. Enjoy your weekend, and as soon as we get updates on when things can start again, we will let you know. Take care, guys.
Good morning, everyone. So it's Saturday again, and good news out this week that it looks like very shortly we're going to be starting up the classes again. So looking forward to seeing you all, and keep checking back on the Facebook, Instagram pages, and email us as well, because we'll be giving updates on when that's going to be happening, when the class will be starting back, and any time adjustments, because allowing for procedures we've got to put into place. So anyway, back to what we're doing today. So the Viennese waltz, I'm going to go through it quite quickly, but if we break it down into three main moves, okay, So I'm going to be doing the leader steps, and by now Janine will have already have done the follow steps. So let's start with the leader's forwards natural turn. Okay, so what we're going to do, I'm going to do it side on just for now so you can see from the angle, because it does rotate. So with my right foot, I'm going to step forwards, I'm going to step to the side, okay, and close my feet. Okay, again, so forward on the right, so we go forward, side, close. Which for any of you that have done our classes, you'll see that that action is what you've already done through the waltz. So you've done the forward, side, close, and then sometimes backward, side, close to make a box. Or you've done forward, side, close into another position. So then maybe you've turned it there already. Okay, so it's a natural turn, which you've already done part of that in the beginning of your waltz. So from behind, the step will go with the right foot, will go and forward, side, close. So that's the first one. So right foot forward, left foot to the side, close your feet. Okay? Because you've closed with your right foot, your left foot is now free. So now your left foot is going to go backwards. So it goes back on the left, to the side, close. Okay? So I'll show you that sequence again. Forwards on the right, forwards, side, close. Back on the left, back, side, close. Okay? Once more. And forward, side, close. Back with the left foot, back, side, close. So continuing the turn. Okay? Good. So, if I'm starting into this corner, my right foot is going to go forwards, bringing my left side around. Okay? So the rotation here is going to go clockwise. Okay? So we continue to turn clockwise. Turning, turning. Okay, and that gets you round. So that's the basic steps of the natural turn. So you've got the forwards right and the backwards left. Okay? Then that can start again. So right foot again, forwards right, backwards left. And again, forward right and backwards left. One more, forward right and backwards left. Okay? So that's your natural turns. Space is obviously restricted and limited at the moment. So what you would do is make that longer and going down continuously down the floor. However, for now, just to get the action and get you used to the steps, you can use any size of space. So, that's your natural turns. What we'll then do is we'll do the change step, okay? So that gets you from one move into the next move, okay? So, if we've done our forwards right and our backwards left, okay? That then frees up my right foot. So to change my step, what I'm then gonna do is go forwards on the right as I would normally to continue the natural turns. But instead of turning around to the side, what I'm actually going to do is go forwards on the right and step to the side and then close my feet. Okay? So what that does is it changes the turn. Okay? So we were turning, we were rotating around in clockwise. Now what that's done is put a stop to the turn. So then that allows us to start the rotation going the opposite way. Okay, so I'll link that up. So I'm going to go forwards right, backwards left, change step. So forwards right, step to the side, close. Okay, I'll do it on a slightly different angle so you can see it. Forwards, backwards. Okay, now we'll go forward, side, close. Okay, so that's now changed my angle for the next position. So now we have the reverse turns. And the principle behind these is one of us is doing a crossing action whilst the other is doing a close. So when you're with your partnership, it's going to be one is crossing, one is closing. You're not both doing crosses at the same time or both doing the closes at the same time on the reverses. Okay? So, reverses. So I've just done my change step. So I've gone forward, side, close. Now, fabulous. I'm going to start a rotation going anti-clockwise, okay? So I'm going to go left, coming around to the side with the right foot, okay? And then I cross in front. Okay, this one's a bit more confusing. So I've done my change step. My left foot's free, so I go left to the side, rotating anti-clockwise, and then I cross. Okay, so my foot goes from this position across. Once more, forward, side, close, left foot's free, so left foot forward, right foot starts to come around, left foot crosses in front. Okay, that's the important thing, it's in front, it's not behind, in front of your right foot. Okay, forward, side, close, left, right foot side, left foot in front. Okay, now what this does is it frees up the right foot to do the next move. Okay, so once more, forward, side, close is the change step, left foot, right foot to the side, left foot in front. Now, to continue this turn, what we're going to do is we're going to go back on the right foot, continuing the turn, back on the right foot, to the side of the left foot and close the feet. Okay? So if I'm in my crossed position, I go back with the right, to the side of the left, and close my feet. Okay? Do this from behind, so I'm in the cross position, opposite way around. So I'm going to go back on the right, to the side with the left, and close my feet. Okay? So you have your crossing action, then you have a normal closing action, as normal as this is. So, change step. Okay, we're going to do the cross, left foot, left, right, cross in front, back on the right, back to the side, close the feet. Okay? We'll do it from the front so you can start to see the back end of the rotation. Change step, left to the side, cross in front, back to the side, close the feet. Okay? And that will repeat. So, do that again. So from here, left to the side. I'd already done the cross. My mistake. So from the cross, back on the right, back to the side, close the feet. Sorry, I'd already done that part. Now you're going to do the left. So you go left to the side, cross in front, back to the side, close the feet. And again, left, left to the side, cross in front, back to the side, close the feet. Once more, left to the side, cross in front, back to the side, close the feet. Okay, so your rotation is the opposite way to what we did on the natural turns. That's the key thing to remember. Don't try and make it go the same way because it won't. Your feet will get twisted and it's impossible to do. So, so to recap, we've got natural turns, go clockwise, okay? Right foot, so we go right, side, close, left back, side, close, right forward, side, close, left back, side, close, okay? Then we have the change step, which is a right foot, forwards, forward, side, close. That changes our rotation, okay? Now we're going the opposite way, so we're going to go on the left foot, left, side, cross, back, side, close, left, side, cross, back, side, close. Okay, and then to link that back so you can do it again onto the naturals, you're going forwards on the left foot. So you go forwards on the left, to the side, close, and then it frees up your right foot to do the natural turn. So then you go forward, right, forward, side, close, back, side, close, forward, side, close, back, side, close. Change step, forward, right, forward, side, close. Reverses, left foot, left side cross, back side close. And again, left side cross, back side close. Change steps of forwards left, forward side close. Freeze up the right foot to do the natural turns. Okay, so on this video, I've just done four of the naturals, change step, four of the reverses, and then change step. Okay. In terms of full sets, it's two and two, but in terms of individual steps out, it is four. So give that a go. Normally on a sequence, when you have a larger floor, you would be doing possibly an 8 and a 6 sequence. So 8 natural turns to 6 reverse turns. But it all depends on the room that you're in, and also the amount of like corner angles you have to cut into and where people are as well. So there's a lot of factors to put into place on that. But give that a go in terms of the sequence and the pattern, because we can develop that in the classes once you've got the basics. So we look forward to seeing you all soon. We're nearly there, not long now, not long, and we'll all be back. Thank you. But something felt so wrong.